Hey you guys, welcome back to our channel, the number one place for people who love design, art and everything creative. My name is Laszlo, I do graphic design and illustration here at DMB, and today's video is all about app icon design. As all of you iPhone users are probably know by now, the latest iOS 14 update lets you customize your iPhone's aesthetic. You probably have seen all these screenshots of people's customized iPhone layouts online. iOS 14 has enabled us to customize our home screen to an extent that has never been allowed before on Apple devices. And for us designers, this is pretty exciting news. So when I first heard about this thing, I thought this is going to be huge and we creatives should all jump on it while the topic is still hot. So I have set myself this little side project of building the ultimate Christmas iOS 14 home screen layout. I have designed 40 unique handcrafted, well, Adobe Illustrator crafted icons of the most popular apps of 2020. This has been my little secret side project since early October, and I am ecstatic that I have managed to finish it just before we get into December. But enough about me. I don't want this video to be a 10-minute long advert of me trying to find different ways of asking you to buy my icon set. So I thought I would show you how I made one of them so you can go and make your own sets. I did a little YouTube search and it looks like no one has made a messenger app icon design tutorial in Illustrator for this new Facebook logo yet, so I want to fill in this gap. The first half of this video is going to be me showing you how you can redesign this icon in Illustrator step by step from scratch. And once we are done with that, I'll show you how I modified the design to make it look a bit more Christmassy. Interested? Let's jump in. So let's open up Illustrator and start a new document. Since we are designing scalable vectors, it doesn't really matter what size canvas you open. I tend to start with a landscape A3. Make sure it's RGB colored. Okay, that's good. Now let's open up our search engine of choice and look for some reference images. Essentially, we are looking for an image that will most likely be a pixel-based JPEG of our app icon. And we're gonna use that as a guide to build our scalable vector graphic. I have brought in some app icons because I need to make sure my curved rectangles in the background will look exactly like these. Then I copy and paste in the actual Facebook Messenger logos. This one is the most important one, as even though this is the old blue logo, it's got all the right ratios of the logo within the rounded square, so I will use this as a centerpiece of my tracing. Now let's start with recreating the white background. I'm gonna take the opacity of my reference image down a little, then I wanna lock this object. You can go Object, Lock, or just hit Ctrl and 2 or Command 2 to lock your selected objects. Now go to your rectangle tool and holding down the Alt key, draw out a perfect square. When I trace stuff like this, I find it's a good idea to take the opacity of your design down and use a weird color that will show through your tracing so you can see what you're doing. Keep holding down the Alt key as you modify your square so it stays in shape. Once that's done, we need to bring in the corners by grabbing one of these little white dots. Literally just bring them in and match it with the curve, like so. Take your time with this, make sure it's as close as possible to your reference. Okay, now we have our background, so we can change its color to white and bring the opacity back to 100%. Now let's move on to the speech bubble. Now since it's a relatively simple shape, I think we don't need to manually recreate it by playing around with circles and the pen tool. It's enough to unlock this JPEG, then go and trace image, just like that. Now I want to separate the bubble from this little lighting bolt, so I duplicate it and separate them using the Shape Builder tool. Select all your work, then drag the two elements together with the Shape Builder to make the bubble, and on another version you hold down the Alt key, then drag your cursor from the outside of the shape to subtract the bubble from the lighting, just like that. A little insight here for you. 99% of the time, every element is perfectly centered in these app icons. So if you select all three parts, then click on one of the objects as a reference point, you can align the other two objects to it. So you just go align, then center vertically, and then center horizontally as well. Now we basically recreated the old Messenger logo, so all we need to do is set up this new color gradient. As far as I can tell, it's a free color gradient. You see it's blue, purple, and there's a little bit of bright neon orange there as well. So what you want to do is first of all select these colors from the JPEG and drag and drop them onto your swatches panel. You literally take the color from here on the bottom left and you drag and drop it into your colors. Now obviously, since it's a gradient, there are like millions of different shades within this graphic, so what you wanna do is try to look for the sharpest of these three shades to pick out for your swatches. Now, if you worked with gradients in Illustrator before, you know it can only be applied in two ways. You can either set up a linear gradient and then put this onto a slight angle, which looks almost like the real deal but not quite, as we are missing this nice little curve. So, to make a perfect version of this, let me share my little magic trick with you. What we need is a radial gradient that sort of goes through the speech bubble in a slightly offset way, coming from the bottom right. So to do that, you need to draw out a big circle shape, set it up with your three gradient colors in the gradient panel, and set it as a radial gradient. Then what you wanna do is copy a speech bubble shape on top of this. Here you can see I put a temporarily yellow stroke on it, just so I can see what I'm doing. Now try to match the speech bubble's position so the gradient goes through it the way it does on your reference JPEG. Once you think you are on the right spot, I want you to put your speech bubble stroke to none, then select these two elements, the bubble as well as this new big circle. Now with both of them selected, you go Object, Clipping Mask, Make. Ta-da! Pretty cool, right? We basically masked off the unnecessary parts of the big circle using the speech bubble shape as its little guide. Now, if you double click on this, you can still move things around within the design if you think you didn't get it quite right the first time. With the big circle selected, you can also go back to your gradient settings and change the colors if you want to. Like here, I made my neon orange a little bit sharper, but that's basically it. Now, if you center this onto your rounded rectangle and get the little white lighting bolt on top as well, we have recreated the new Facebook Messenger logo. Happy days! Okay, time to turn this into a Christmas themed icon. I thought since it's a circular bubble, what we could do is make the logo look like one of those swirly, Christmassy lollipops, so I pulled in a reference image. It's pretty simple to do, all I want is to create these white lines on top, so I draw out a line with the line tool. Let's say 2 points wide, zoom in a little bit. Then I wanna use the width tool. So with these two selected, I click on one of my endpoints on the line and drag it slightly to the side to get this narrow, triangular shaped line, just like that. Then I want to copy this line, flip it over, and put it at the endpoint of the first line so it looks like one continuous line that starts out wide, narrows in the middle, then gets big again. Hit Ctrl or Command G to group them. Then I want to copy this. Hit Ctrl C, then Ctrl Shift V to paste your copy at the exact same place of the original one. With this new copy selected, I want you to put this horizontally into place by dragging it to the side. If you hold down Shift while dragging, it's going to put it into the perfect horizontal angle, by the way. Yeah, now group this and copy and paste it in place again. Then same as earlier, you put this to the side while you hold down Shift and let it go somewhere in between these lines, so we basically have this little star shape. At this point, I thought it would be a good idea to put this over our speech bubble so we can see in real time how will this look in the end. Now select your line shapes and go Effect Warp. This brings up this window where you can twist your shape and see how it will look if you got preview ticked. Once you are happy with your swirls, hit OK, then let's bump up the line weight a little, or a lot actually. 34 points look about right for me. Now since our app icon bracket in iOS is actually white, we are essentially done here, but we are professionals, right? So we want to make a pixel perfect design. So to cut these lines in the right place, let's bring in another speech bubble shape on top, then put its fill and stroke to none, then let's mask off these lines with the shape. So select your newly designed swirly line work and this invisible speech bubble on top, then again you go Object, Clipping Mask, Make. Boom! Pixel perfection right there. Again, nothing is finalized here, so if you wanna go back and change the amount of the angle of your swirls, go for it, otherwise it's all done. All that's left to do is save this up the right way. First of all, let's scale this up to, I would say, at least 1000 pixels on each side. Oh yeah, and make sure that you have the scale corners option ticked, otherwise this upscaling will change your rounded rectangle. Then you put this onto asset export and save it out as a PNG file. Now, unfortunately, when you make a PNG out of a graphic with masked elements, it will save with all these masked out shapes in place, even if they are transparent. Here you can see we have all this empty space for the big radial gradient circle, so what you have to do is just cut it in shape manually. I don't believe there is a way to save PNGs out with these transparent elements subtracted, but I might be wrong here. If you know of a better way to do that, help us out and leave it in the comments, please. Other than that, we are done here. So, that's basically how you do it. By the time this video gets in front of you, I imagine you would have seen a bunch of different iOS 14 icon sets. Some of them are quite great, some of them are of weaker quality. I think the trick is to make a good one. You have to develop an understanding of how the original icon has been built up and why does it work so well for its respective brands that it's trying to represent. And for that, this sort of master copying, recreating, it's a great exercise. Again, if you cannot be asked to do any of this, you can buy my icon set if you want from our website. I'll leave a link down below somewhere there. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up because that really does help out our channel and we do appreciate that a great deal. And feel free to join our little design tribe if you're interested in this sort of content. We make videos about illustration, graphic design, interiors, architecture, all of that good stuff. Take care guys and I'll see you this time next week with another video. Bye!